Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll learn about the new Events Viewer visualization available in Dashboard Studio.
While there are a ton of different visualizations available in Dashboard Studio, sometimes all you need is a good old-fashioned list of events. The new Events Viewer visualization offers just that. We can display events, see field data, and even execute any configured workflow actions. From the homepage of the Search and Reporting app, we navigate to the Dashboards tab and select the Buttercup Games Sales Dashboard. To add the Events Viewer visualization, we select Edit, then navigate to the Add Chart menu and select Events. The panel is added, and we adjust the positioning on the canvas. Now to set up a data source. We select an existing data source that searches for Buttercup Games web events, which we can see is currently unused by any other visualization. Immediately, we see the visualization update with events, and the configuration menu appears on the right. Similar to other visualization options, we have the ability to toggle to a different chart option or provide a title and description. The events visualization supports two data sources. The primary data source is the one that will be used to return results to display in the visualization. If we expand an event to view the fields menu, it looks a little different than usual. Selecting a field, rather than more information, a message appears indicating we need to configure the field summary data source, along with an SPL example of how to do so. Let's navigate back to the configuration menu and select a field summary data source. While we can use an ad hoc search that is nearly identical to the primary data source we selected, it would be more efficient to create a chain search, which extends the primary search to add the field summary command. To create the chain search, we select the parent search as Buttercup Web Events, give the data source a name, then write the search. We pipe to the field summary command and specify a max vals of 20. This argument limits the number of values returned for each field that appears in the fields menu. To save the new chain search data source, we select Apply and Close. Now that the field summary data source is configured, when we select a field, we see information like the event coverage, top values, and quick reports under Actions. The Event Actions menu is also present, offering users the ability to build event types, extract fields, show the source, and as of Splunk Cloud 9.0.2305, execute any existing workflow actions. Workflow actions can also be executed from the Fields menu. Navigating back to the Configuration menu, we find even more customization options available, like toggling the visibility based on data availability, position and size, displaying the field summary data, or even adding a background color. Scrolling to the very bottom, we find the visualization ID and source code window, which allows us to preview the JSON source code for the panel. By selecting Expand Editor, we can enlarge the source window to be a lot larger and easier to read or edit if necessary. Once we are done, selecting Collapse Editor will return the code window to normal size.
Thanks for joining us to learn more about the new Events Viewer visualization available in Dashboard Studio. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.